The first step would be for Trump to show that he genuinely wants to engage in negotiations to solve a problem. What's the meaning of negotiations when you impose sanctions at the same time? Trump's talk is either about gaining domestic political advantage in the elections or waging psychological war against the Iranian people.
You just heard Hassan Rouhani talking about psychological warfare. So some pretty tough language from him. But the reality is he's in quite a difficult position at home, isn't he? There's already been protests in the streets. Yeah. What does he do now?
Well, look, you saw his face, right? You know, the body language says a lot, too. This is clearly a man who's trying to put a brave face on an absolutely horrible situation for him. He never thought he was going to be here. And he's doing it in a way he's in a very fragile situation. Like you said, look, the Iranian rial has lost massive amounts of value in the last 6 months of this year, the Iranian currency. You have extremely high unemployment and rising. You have high inflation. You have those protests, these popular protests against the government. The people soon aren't going to be making a distinction between, oh, our moderate President Hassan Rouhani and the hardliners. And it really is that. He is literally, when I say between a rock and a hard place, he's up against the American president, the rock, and the hard place being the hardliners in his own clerical establishment, and including the Supreme Leader of Iran, the Ayatollah Khamenei. So what does he do? What if you do, if you're, you know, he could fall from power. The hardliners have been dead set against the Iran nuclear deal from the very start. Trump pulling out of this deal is like manna from heaven for the hardline establishment, and they've been waiting for this day. So they have been looking to undermine the deal. They've been looking for any pretext which will make Rouhani's position that much harder. I just want to quickly show our viewers exactly what the sanctions are to show them how hard it will be. First round, which comes into effect, has come into effect as of midnight last night, they're sort of not actually the most severe sanctions, right? They affect the rial, the Iranian currency, the purchase of the dollar, trade in things like aircraft, which is important because Iran has some of the highest rate of aircraft accidents, airplane crashes in the world. So buying spare parts for planes is extremely, extremely important. So it's a little hypocritical when Trump says he cares about the Iranian people. If he really cared, he'd allow Iranian industry to get parts for their planes to make them safer. Automobiles, giant, giant sector. That's going to be affected, obviously. And carpets, pistachios, you might laugh and say that's a nothing little thing. It's very symbolic, big symbolic Iranian products. The real things are going to bite in, the real sanctions are going to bite in round two coming up in November. This is where it all kicks in. And it's going to be the oil and petroleum, the gas and petroleum sector, i.e., oil, and the Iranian Central Bank. And this is where all the financial transactions are going to be affected. And this is where, this is, you know, what, two and a half months down the road, this is where we really see the resilience of the Iranian economy, but also the political resilience of a moderate president who has been hanging literally by a thread right now. And any little thing could perhaps tip that balance or snap that thread.
Indeed, we'll have to wait and see serious stuff there in Iran. Thank you very much indeed. Douglas Herbert there from our International Affairs Desk. Let's bring you